This Glock handgun converted into a fully automatic weapon. Investigators now say it was among these items recovered by local deputies during a recent traffic stop. The Flagler County Sheriff's Office released that new information today, saying the Florida Department of Law Enforcement analyzed the Glock 17 handgun in its crime lab and determined it had been converted.
And according to the Sheriff's Office, the weapon was seized during the arrest of a Georgia fugitive late last month. News 4 Jax reporter Eric Avenier joins us live. Eric, this is really concerning to local law enforcement.
Well, yes, it's a concern to law enforcement because they consider that converted handgun to now be a machine handgun capable of mowing down people in a matter of seconds. Keep in mind that machine guns are illegal here in the U.S. unless you have a special federal firearms license, or if that firearm was built before 1986. And investigators say neither one of those conditions apply in this case.
Just 2 weeks after 23-year-old Benjamin Bowie was arrested in Jacksonville on drug charges, he was pulled over in Flagler County for a traffic violation that led to him being arrested on a warrant out of Georgia for Grand Theft Auto. When the arresting deputy searched Bowie's vehicle, he found marijuana along with multiple firearm magazines, ammunition, a rubber skeleton mask, and a ski mask. The guns were sent to the FDLE crime lab, where investigators discovered one of the guns, a Glock 17, had been illegally converted into a fully automatic handgun.
Any firearm that is used for criminal reasons or has alterations to make it perform outside of the way it was intended obviously creates a higher risk to us.
Here's an example of what a fully automatic Glock 17 looks like when fired. That was more than 20 rounds fired under 3 seconds. News for Jax crime and safety expert Ken Jefferson says a concealed automatic weapon this small in the hands of criminals on the streets not only poses a danger for law enforcement, but also the general public.
Because of all of the power that these weapons have and the kick that it has, unless you are very, very proficient in handling it and knowing what the kick is going to be, it can get out of control, and there could be a lot of innocent people, innocent bystanders.
Chief Welker says while law enforcement is concerned about this kind of weapon on the streets, they are more worried about the individual in possession of it.
So their motives, the things that they're looking to do, that's really where the focus is.
And then there's another question still looming. How many of these converted handguns are currently on the streets in the wrong hands?
If one person knows how to convert it, you can best believe that there are more than knows how to convert it as well. Just hadn't come across them yet.
Now, state charges against Bowie are just the least of his concerns because investigators say they plan to get the ATF involved to see if federal charges could be filed against him. Now, coming up at 11, you're going to hear why a local gun rights attorney says every law-abiding citizen who is allowed to have a firearm should be allowed to own that fully automatic handgun. Reporting live, Eric Avenier, Channel 4, the local station.
So, Eric, if convicted, what kind of time is Bowie facing behind bars?
Well, get this. At the state level on state charges, he's looking at up to 15 years in state prison. Now, if he is convicted on the federal level, he is looking at a mandatory minimum of at least 10 years in prison. If convicted on both levels, he would wind up facing, obviously, in jail in the state prison level and then transferred eventually after finishing that sentence to the federal prison. Also, don't forget that he has criminal cases both here in Jacksonville, also in Georgia, that are felony cases that have yet to be adjudicated. So that also plays a role in sentencing if convicted. Mary?
All right, Eric Avenier reporting to us live. Thanks, Eric.